So, Richmond Hill, how do you like your orchestra? I can't tell you how delighted I am to have so much talent, and these people are probably even finer people than they are musicians. So you're absolutely fantastic. So, there's a bit of a theme to this concert, as you know, but there's two part theme. The first half was kind of all about water, and this half is all about land. In 1884, Dvorak's growing success as a composer allowed him to build a small cottage far from the city hustle and bustle. He said, "There I am a poet as well as a musician." His daily schedule always included long walks, and he loved to watch for birds and enjoy the rolling countryside. One of his favorite hobbies was keeping pigeons, and if he attended a meal where a pigeon was served, he left the table completely offended. As he was approaching his 50th birthday, he decided to express the deep influence of his rustic surroundings in musical ideas. In Nature's Realm, the next piece we'll play, was one of a set of three overtures he composed to celebrate nature, life, and love. Dvorak wrote, "On a summer evening, man finds himself in the seemingly silent realm of nature. His ear can only hear one indistinct long tone, the voice of slumbering nature. And here and there, a bird makes itself heard. Suddenly, when the mind has shaken off the burden of its everyday troubles and gladly surrendered to the all-embracing arms of nature, the inner voice of nature begins to vibrate in the soul. At first, it sounds tenderly, as if from afar, but it grows, strengthens, and rises quickly until it bursts out in tones of exhilarating, pure joy. Nature sings the symphony of her great mystery, the symphony of life and love. And man, surrounded by this jubilant hymn, feels ennobled, full of joy and strength. Fortified in his soul, his mind returns to reality while nature hovers over him, murmuring again in her long, deep silence, interrupted only by an occasional bird's cry."